In this first lecture, we will be talking about four fundamental interactions, and I'll also introduce elementary particles in brief. So the four fundamental interactions are gravitational interaction, electromagnetic interaction, strong interaction, and weak interaction. Gravitational interaction, it is the interaction between two massive bodies which are kept at some distance. Electromagnetic interaction, it is the interaction between charged particles. Strong interaction is responsible for strong nuclear force. This is the interaction which keeps your neutrons and protons together inside a nucleus. Weak interaction, this is the interaction between subatomic particles and is responsible for particle decays. Like you have your beta decay, where your neutron decays into proton, electron and an antineutrino. Hence, that is an example of your weak interaction. Okay, now coming to your comparative study of these interactions. So, this column we have your interactions, here we have range and then the exchange particles. So, range meaning till what extent this interaction can be felt, right? And the exchange particles meaning, so when particles are interacting via a strong interaction or a weak interaction or an electromagnetic interaction, then these particles, they exchange something between them, right? So, that whatever they are exchanging, that is called your exchange particle. And for each interaction, we have different exchange particles. So, for gravitational interaction, the range is infinite. So, that means the gravitational interaction can be felt at infinite ranges. Then, the exchange particle is graviton. For electromagnetic interaction, the range is infinite and the exchange particle is photon. The strong interaction, the range is about 10 to the power minus 15 meters. So, this quantity here is in meters. So, 10 to the power minus 15 meters. Meaning, strong interaction cannot be felt at a distance which is greater than 10 to the power minus 15 meters. The exchange particle here is gluons. And for weak interaction, the range is about 10 to the power minus 17 to 10 to the power minus 18 meters. And the exchange particles are W plus minus and Z0 bosons. Okay, so now let me introduce elementary particles in brief. So before introducing the elementary particles, I want to introduce few parameters which is assigned to the elementary particles, and these are very important parameters. So the first parameter is mass. So you have particles which are light massed or intermediate mass, or your heavy mass particles, right? So, the first parameter is mass. The second parameter is spin. So, you have particles with integral spin. The particles with integral spin are called bosons, and the particles with half integral spins are called fermions. So, you have elementary particles, both the spins, right? So, you have some particles are bosons and some are fermions. Similarly, the other parameter is charge. You have some particles which are charged, right, which are positively charged, which are neutral, and some particles which are negatively charged, right? So, now, next such parameter is your parity. So, you have parity as plus 1 or minus 1. So, parity meaning space reversal. So, you have particles whose parity is plus 1 and also particles which have their parity as minus 1. So, next comes lifetime. So, now you have particles which are stable and also you have particles which are unstable. So, stable particles, they do not decay, or even if they do, they have very large lifetime, and then there are particles which are unstable, right? So, that means they are going to decay. So, these were the few parameters. Now, let us divide the particles based on their interactions, right? So, this is the most elegant way of classifying the particles. So, that means based on their interactions, right? So, first, you have the leptons. I mean, the broad category is the leptons and the hadrons, right? So, this actually is divided on the basis of your strong interactions, because leptons, they do not feel strong interactions, and hadrons are the ones which are going to feel strong interaction. So, under leptons, Like the most common example you might be knowing is are the electrons. Also, we have muons and the tauons. And also, we must remember that their respective neutrinos and antineutrinos are also leptons. So, leptons are classified into first generation, second generation and the third generation. So, the first generation are your electrons and then the electron neutrinos, right? And also their antiparticles. And in second generation, you have your muons. Muons and then the muon neutrino and also their antiparticles, and in third generation you have your tauons and tauon neutrinos and then their antiparticles, right? Okay, and under hadrons, the ones which are going to experience or ones which are going to face strong interactions are your hadrons, and these hadrons are divided into mesons and baryons. So under I'll be telling it later when I'll be introducing quarks, but the main difference between mesons and baryons is on their quark structure. So mesons are going to have q bar, and the baryons are going to have 3 q's or 3 q bars, right? So I'll be introducing that little later. So for now you can consider the hadrons being divided into mesons and baryons. So under mesons you have pions, kions and etas. So I mean these are the examples of your mesons. And under baryons, you have your nucleons and hyperons, right? So, nucleons, you know, are protons and neutrons. And hyperons, these are the particles, these are the baryons, which are little heavier than your nucleons. So, hence, hyperons. So, the hyperons are, the first one is sigma, the second one is your cascade, the third one is your omega, and the fourth one is your lambdas. So that's it for your today's lecture, the first lecture. So where we have learnt about the four fundamental forces, their comparative study, we have introduced elementary particles, and we have seen what are the basic parameters these particles have, and also we have divided the particles based on their strong interaction. Thank you.